So here I'm back with today I'm here with the negative impact of the British Empire. So talking about the negative impact, I can talk about the zamindari system, their permanent land settlement, which brought about abject poverty. There was absolute poverty. And talking about their destruction of handicrafts, we can talk about rampant unemployment and also killing the skills forever. Traditional skills, which were handed over from father to son, etc., came to an end, which was very sad. And then we're talking about the managing agency system that helped get about 50% of the profit of all the consumer goods industries. And we will talk about the complete control over the Indian markets by the Britishers. That was a negative impact of the British rule. And though they did have a positive balance of trade, surplus balance of trade, they used it for their own services and put it down as home charges, and helplessly looked at it without, we couldn't say much about it. And we became a primary producing economy, producing raw materials. So please have a look while I can still go. I'm going to repeat what I just said right now. So negative impact means that we sort of, the zamindari system that they introduced by the permanent land settlement of theirs, the lagan, etc., they were insensitive to the people's condition, and they wanted their rent. So that brought us on our knees to abject poverty, absolute poverty. And then the world-famous handicrafts that were found here in our urban areas, they were absolutely destroyed. Then even the they through their managing agency system, they took away about 50% of the gross profit of the consumer goods industries developed by them in India. So that was also there. And then they exploited the Indian economy through the economic drain. I mean, even the money that they got, the foreign exchange, they just frittered it away, saying that they were home charges for some services, for the services that they provided. And then Indian economy now was like a primary producing economy that is exporting only agricultural products and raw materials and importing basically British goods, manufactured goods. And they gained complete control over the entire Indian markets through their discriminatory policy or tariff policy. So basically, this was the negative impact of the British on the Indian economy. So with that, we have got a view of a bird's eye view of what our economy looked like when the Britishers left India on the eve of independence. So we'll be doing question answers later on, but now I think I'll go on to the next chapter, that is after independence. We're going to talk about planning. That's what we'll do.